And now, continuing on at the Toronto Film Festival here on the Stephen Holt Show, we're sitting here with Academy Award winner Mira Sorvino. Hey, Mira.
Hey, Stephen.
And the director, Nancy Savoca.
Hi, Stephen.
Of this wonderful new film called Union Square, strangely enough. Oh, there's a poster. And you're there with one of my dearest friends, Tammy Blanchard.
Who
I didn't recognize in this movie.
She's a chameleon. She's a chameleon, absolutely.
I mean, this is a very different role for her, and what a part for you, my dear.
I know. I read it, and I was like, wow, okay. I got lucky. I got very blessed that Nancy thought of me for this.
Because you start off the film in Union Square, sort of like having a nervous breakdown.
Yes.
And that's just the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, yes. Yes, I kind of lose it in public. I'm on the phone with a sort of a lover. I'm not even really sure if they really are, but in her mind they are. And he's breaking up with her, but she's kind of goading him into it. What are you saying? Are you breaking up with me? Are you breaking up with me? And she just loses it. And, you know, people, kids all around, and just starts kicking her shopping bag. She's just been on an incredible shopping spree at Filene's.
Which is what,
right?
You do,
yeah.
Before
at Filene's,
you have a meltdown.
Yeah.
You go to the shopping and then you have your meltdown.
Yeah.
That's how it works, right? At least that's how it works for
right, us. Right. I thought, my God, you shop a lot at Filene's. I do too, but anyway. And I have to keep saying, Tammy Blanchard is starring on Broadway right now on How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. And I am very proud to say the Stephen Holt Show helped get her that Tony nomination. She didn't win, but we had her on and she just talked about getting one endlessly and she got it.
That's so good.
For a very different role than she's playing in your movie. And since Tammy isn't here, you two worked so well together.
Thank you.
And I didn't know at the beginning of the film, I thought, is that Tammy? I knew it was you, but like, who is that woman too? I was nice that you didn't find out until a bit later that they were sisters.
How they're related. What's fascinating to me, and what I loved watching as a director every day, watching these two working with each other, is that they are in fact the polar opposite of their characters in real life. So the cameras would stop rolling.
Tammy is not like that.
Totally.
Yes, we know this.
Tammy from Bayonne would look for a hamburger and you'd be eating the curried tofu that we had on land. And like, if you look at these characters, they're just playing the opposite of each other. It's like so cool to watch them morph into and truly, honestly inhabit these creatures. It was so much fun to watch them. So much fun.
And Mira, of course, is, you know, you're quite famous, you know, and so going to Mira, who's the star, to get in your film is a wonderful thing. But I was surprised, you know, especially at Tammy's casting, how you thought of her for this.
We just picked the best people for the role, and knowing what they do through our casting director.
Okay.
No, I had the same feeling that I had seen her in several movies and sort of went, who's with Tammy Blanchard, who, whatever. But I think what happened to me is like seeing the two of them and what potentially they could do together. All I could do is put them together and then just be surprised every day at what they brought to it, which was taking what was in the script and just running with it and turning it into with improv and energy that was just, I'm telling you, I was in the best seat in the house. I had a blast watching.
Well, I love films with great actresses giving a great performance like you always do, Mira. I mean, unfailingly,
thanks.
She, you know, it's magnificent.
You
know.
Sweet. Thank you.
And the fabulous legs and the fabulous, I have to ask, who's the shoes by? Oh my
Mew
God.
Mew.
Who?
Mew Mew.
Okay,
yeah.
All right, you
yeah.
said it. Looking so fabulous at the Toronto Film Festival this hour of the morning. And you had the really, really difficult task at the beginning of the film to start off, like, as we said, a nervous breakdown. Like,
right.
And then
and
where do you go from that?
Oh, I was so afraid that the audience would just be like, I can't take this woman, get me away from her. And that's exactly how her sister feels
when
she rings the doorbell. And I ring
right.
it incessantly. I ring it like 25 times. I try and look through the keyhole.
Mira,
you know.
I've done that too. I've been there more than I've been bending it, okay.
But you know, she has a really good heart and she's funny, so you get over her histrionics after a little while, or they're just sort of part of the roller coaster ride that the film takes you on. And I was nervous initially that first scene might overwhelm people, but I think it lasts just long enough and then it's over, because now we're on to me with the sister and me ruining her life rather than my life being ruined.
That your character is a messenger of some truisms.
Yes.
So she comes in with some truths, and it's surprising to have that happen. I don't want to reveal anything, but it's surprising what
how
ends
can
up,
we do
how
talk about this film without revealing too much? Okay, well, we can talk about the Bronx, which is where I'm from and where the characters in this film are from.
There you go. Where are you from? Me too.
Oh no!
Oh my God!
Oh my God! OMG! Okay, it's I'm from Parkchester.
I worked at Macy's in Parkchester.
So did my mother.
I probably knew her.
Oh my God, Mrs. Holt. Yeah.
China Silver Glass.
Oh my God. Yeah. Oh my God.
Glass.
Yeah. So it's very Bronx specific, this film. Now, you're not from the Bronx.
I was born in Manhattan and moved to New Jersey when I was 3.
Okay.
But it's not, you know, my grandparents were from Brooklyn, so they were from a borough. My
and
father
your
was
father, of course,
raised partially in Brooklyn, and I have cousins from Jersey City. So all the outer boroughs are kind of, they share things in common, especially among the Italian Americans, and the characters are Italian American.
But there's something about the Bronx, isn't there?
Yeah,
there's something about
40 minutes on the 5, and you actually leave the borough, which most people don't. Yeah, the Mira inhabited the Bronx in a way. There were times when I was like listening to her talk, and I'm like, oh my God. And Rich was like, she sounds like you.
I tried to use you as a template. And at the end of the movie, you were like, actually, I don't really know how you actually speak. You know,
because
I've been working on the voice and the accent so much. You know, I just tried to stay in it all the time.
It was scary. I didn't realize until the editing room that you sounded like you were really doing a lot of the accent that, obviously, and our DP was from the Bronx, so she was surrounded by Bronx women.
I have more of a Bronx accent than you do.
Give me a couple of whatever wines and relax and it comes out.
The Stephen Holt show rolls on
a little bit more.
But there's something about the Bronx that it's in this movie, Union Square, which is not set in the Bronx, but characters are from the Bronx, but it just permeates the Bronx. We never can leave it, can we? Nancy?
Lucy Mira's character.
We can't get away from it.
No, it's in you. But Mira's character leaves the Bronx for the day. I mean, and that's kind of like her ta-da of being in Union Square.
This is like the biggest journey she's ever taken.
Yeah, she's so surprised that she takes the subway and suddenly she's in a new world, and that's what her experience is all about.
Union Square will never be the same. And that's the name of the movie, Union Square. And you had a very interesting way of, I mean, you're another graduate of NYU Film School. I mean, and you had a reading the production notes, you had a very interesting way of how you set this film up, because you had limitations and in space and time and
yeah, we all did.
You rehearsed the technicians as much as you rehearsed more than you rehearsed the actors, because you had, tell them.
Well, we had a week to rehearse just us, where we both basically spoke about the family set up in the background with Tammy.
And Mike Rispoli.
And so Mike Doyle. We had the guys in the movie.
There are men in this film too, yes.
Yes, there are the men there. But then at the same time, I basically prepared the technicians, because we couldn't rehearse the technicians because we didn't know what the actors were going to do. And this movie's very actor oriented. So the
Which
cameras
I love,
followed,
by the way,
followed.
Yeah.
Whatever they were doing, we had to go. So it was a sort of this funny mix of like documentary style and reality show style in some weird way. It's got a little bit of that feel too, especially
like
when
the
you
Stephen
burst
Hill
in.
Show does today, yes.
Like, yes. It's feeling like this right now, actually, yeah.
Yeah, it's had Kevin's following it. He's from Pennsylvania, so like he doesn't know what we're talking about in the Bronx.
He's terrified.
Yeah, he's terrified.
Sorry.
But I was happy to see the Bronx like represented quite so completely. Did you go there? Did you go to the Bronx to do any research?
I had been to the Bronx to do research for Summer of Sam, because that character is from the Bronx too. And I had been there to do research also for Gary Winnick's movie, Sweet Nothing. And, you know, recently he passed away very sadly of brain cancer. But that was also, that character was also from the Bronx. So I had already done my Bronx.
You've done your Bronx time, honey. You've done it. Yeah, you knew. Yeah. But there's something else about it that's like the Bronx, I think, there's a kind of an underdog thing. It's like Queens is a little more proper and Brooklyn's like Brooklyn. But the Bronx...
the Bronx is never going to be hip.
Never.
I don't think it's ever going to be hip. No, that's why, like, Lucy shows up and she's just, yeah, she's just a
she
tourist.
She explodes like the Bronx does into your life. And then relieves it. So she basically, in the first few minutes of the movie, your character Lucy moves in to the apartment on Union Square.
Finds a good couch.
And that's it. She's there. She's done.
Not my apartment. My sister's apartment. I barge in after a 3-year estrangement.
Yeah.
And then I'm oh, this is, it's a nice couch. You know, just she just finds her place. She starts lying down. She brings a dog out. You know, yeah. It's all.
The dog is in the bag.
That's her dog, by the way.
That's my
the dog.
Yeah.
Murray, he's a dog, but he's not a dog.
Yes, does Tammy have a thing about dogs?
Well, Tammy's character has a thing about dogs, especially on her couch.
You know who has a thing about dogs? Woody Allen.
Oh.
Did you know that he hates animals?
I think I read that somewhere, but that was never apparent when we worked together.
Speaking of Woody Allen, this is one of his Academy Award-winning actresses. God, he just likes keep. You didn't know he hates animals. And Owen Wilson would bring for this other wonderful movie, Midnight in Paris, which I've seen 8 times.
You're one of those people who's seen it 8 times. Okay, I've heard. My girlfriend has too. I have to see it. Okay.
But Owen Wilson brought his dog on the set every day, and Woody hates dogs. And Owen Wilson was the lead in the movie. Did anything like that happen on Mighty Aphrodite, which you won your Oscar for? Nothing.
No.
What was it like working with...
It was wonderful. It was really wonderful. I was super shy at that point, and so I was just trying to be obedient and quiet and wait in the wings to come out and do Linda Ash. And then
was a porn star?
No, not a star, sadly. A porn, like, B player, a day player, you know?
Everybody in porn is a star.
But, no, she was, I had such a big character developed for her, and I was so nervous about losing it that I stayed in character all day, very method-like. And I got a note from his photographer that Woody didn't like method actors and thought it was strange that I stayed in the voice all day. And I said, but if I don't, I'm going to lose it. And he says, yeah, and he also thinks you're a bit aloof, a bit unfriendly. And I was like, oh, no, because I'm just waiting for my orders. Like, I just want to please. And he said, well, you know, he likes actors who are friendly, who like hang out. So I decided to take that note. And then every day I would go, hello, Mr. Allen. And so I talked to him all day, like in the voice, but I'd still, you know, I talked to him about everyday subjects, but I'd be Linda. And he enjoyed it, actually.
Did you have any idea, and this is my last question, when you were doing it, that this was going to be a role that would end up winning you an Oscar and changing your life?
No, I didn't really know much about the Oscars at that point. I mean, I was really just trying to, you know, make my break in, you know, films and do good work, and I wasn't thinking about the awards. I'd never been nominated for one before, so I didn't really think about it. And then when it came out and then it started getting all this buzz and, you know, the studio got behind it, that was like, oh, okay, that's what happens. Wow. You know, but I knew it was a great role. When I read it, I was like, wow, this is a great role. But it's the same when I read Union Square. I said, this is a great role.
And you just read my mind, because I was going to finish with that line, which is just like Mighty Aphrodite. This is a great role. Lucy and Jenny, both great roles for actresses. I love it. There can't be enough of them. I love your films.
Thank you.
I used
so
to be a
call.
You know what? And I'm winding up. You called in and had a whole interview on the show that I used to call in. I was Stephen from the Bronx on the Lynn Samuels show.
Yes, I recognize Stephen from the Bronx.
So, and Stephen is not from the Bronx anymore. I'm from the Toronto Film Festival here with Mira Sorvino and Nancy Savoca, the director and star of this wonderful new movie, which I loved a lot, Union Square. It's heartwarming, and it'll warm your heart, too. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For being here today.
Thank you. This was fun.
Good, good. And you look fabulous, darling.
Thank you.